Welcome back to Streamers. As we all know, Kargil Vijay Diwas is around the corner. Kargil Vijay Diwas is celebrated on July 26 every year. So today, we are going to talk about heroes of Kargil War. Captain Vikram Batra of 13 Jammu and Kashmir Rifles gave a tagline for Battle Wars, Ye Dil Mange More, which was later turned into a Pepsi slogan. At the age of just 24, he was awarded with PVC posthumously. During this war, he was suffering from high fever, yet he helped India win the Kargil War from Pakistan. Lieutenant Balwant Singh. He is also known as the Tiger of Tiger Hill. He was tasked to capture the Tiger Hill along with his team. He, along with his team, took a difficult route to capture the Tiger Hill. While the Pakistani soldiers thought Indian soldiers could not reach the hilltop using that route. So it was a difficult task, yet he completed it. In a close combat, he killed 4 enemy soldiers. He was later awarded with Mahavir Chakra for his bravery. He is the one who planted the Tiranga on the top of the Tiger Hill. Grenadier Yogendra Singh Yadav. He was just 18 when he was awarded with PVC. He is the youngest one from India to have been awarded with PVC. He was the sole survivor of the attack on Tiger Hill, in which he took 15 bullets and he recaptured 3 bunkers on Tiger Hill, that is on July 4, 1999. Yadav led the assault but halfway through enemy lines opened fire, killed his colleagues. Yadav was himself hit by several bullets which rendered his left arm. Determined to achieve his objective, that is to win the battle for India from Pakistan, he strapped his arm in a belt, wrapped a bandana around his leg and continued to fight with the army. He killed 4 enemy soldiers in close combat and silenced the automatic fire. This gave the rest of the platoon the opportunity to climb up the cliff and capture their positions. Next, we have Major Rajesh Adhikari. On May 14, 1999, he was leading the central arm of 3 10-man teams trying to capture a bunker at 16,000 feet at the Tololing feature. Major Adhikari suffered serious bullets, injured, to which he succumbed beyond enemy lines on May 15. He was the second army officer to be martyred in the Kargil War. His body was recovered 13 days later. In his pocket was an unread letter from his wife. He was posthumously awarded with Mahavir Chakra. Major Vivek Gupta of 2nd Rajputana Rifles was leading a dangerous uphill assault against the Pakistani enemies. He captured 2 bunkers and suffered various bullets from the enemy, which tore open his torso in Dras. The major lay in the snow alongside dead colleagues for 2 days. He died fighting exactly 7 years after being commissioned to Rajputana Rifles. Nayak Digendra Kumar. He is known for his planning strategy to recapture Tololing, that is located at an altitude of 15,000 feet. His plan had surprised the then Army Chief, General V.P. Malik, who held a Sainik Darbar in Dras on June 2, 1990, after 3 failed attempts to get back Tololing. The team of 10 commandos came under heavy firing with 250 Pakistani soldiers. 9 commandos died. But before they handed over their guns and grenades to Nayak Digendra Kumar, who lodged them in all 11 bunkers of the enemy, he killed Major Anwar Khan of Pakistan Army in hand-to-hand combats, slitting enemy's throat with a dagger. He planted the Indian flag on the hilltop before falling unconscious. He woke up in an army hospital. Rifleman Sanjay Kumar. He was once a taxi driver and had been rejected thrice by the army. Today, he is the youngest of three surviving Paramveer Chakra decorated soldiers of Indian Army. During the Kargil War, he was part of a column that was tasked to capture the flat top of Point 4875 in Mushkosh Valley. When automatic fire from one of the enemy bunkers posed stiff opposition and stalled the column, Kumar charged at them head on. He was hit in the leg and hip, but he single-handedly wiped out a bunker after others from his unit had fallen. Lieutenant Manoj Kumar Pandey. According to his father, Manoj Kumar Pandey had the sole ambition of getting Paramveer Chakra, the highest gallantry award. He got one in Kargil conflict posthumously. He and his team was asked to clear enemy positions in order to prevent his battalion from getting exposed in the daylight. The battlefield was of Kalubar. He led his team valiantly and was shot on a ledge, but he made it to the top of the cliff. He busted enemy bunkers before succumbing to bullets. His daredevilry finally led to the recapture of Kalubar. With this, we would like to conclude this vlog. I hope the stories of such soldiers do inspire you. With this, we conclude. Thank you. We'll meet you soon in my next vlog. Thank you.